All right, guys, we're back at it. The last thing we have to remove on the roof is the air conditioning unit. So we're gonna get going on that. And then once we get it removed, that should be it for the roof. We'll start taking off trim with the termination strips. I think that's what they're called, maybe, maybe not. And then we'll start removing the old roofing material, and then we'll see what kind of damage we have up under there. So let me get some tools together and we'll start getting this pulled apart. So it looks like this has, it's got four long bolts that hold these two braces on, and they go up into the unit itself. So let's pull these out. I'm horrible at keeping up with screws and bolts and what they go to, so I like to just put them in a bag, label it, and keep everything together. That's just because I can't do it on my own. These will end up everywhere if I don't do this, so. All right, let's get the rest of these off. All right, so you can see up in here some of those four bolts. We've got our wiring. This piece right here just comes undone. Okay, I think I'm gonna take this little cover plate off and see if I can disconnect these wires. Really, this is the only one here that I need to disconnect. All right, so you can see here, I just undid this one screw, pulled this little cover plate off, and then you can see where these wires come in, there's a little clip on the inside, and once we undo that, that's going to free us from the top unit, since we already have this one disconnected, and we'll be good to go. We've got this disconnected here, we got this one disconnected, which was the one we had to remove the cover for. Everything else should be good to go. That'll free our unit up on top. And I'm not sure how much is gonna be holding that in. So let's get up on top, see if we can clean that up and get it all unscrewed, and we'll try to pull this thing off here. All right, let's see if we can get this thing coming off here. We're gonna work our way around. We've got everything removed up here. Air conditioner's gone, refrigerator vent, fans, skylights. We're gonna start removing the roofing material, and I'm hoping that we're gonna be able to peel it off in large chunks. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to go ahead and just probably cut around these termination points for now, and then I'm gonna get all this and then removed, and then I will come back and start scraping off lap sealant and trying to get those off of there. So that's what we're gonna do at this point. took about 15 minutes total. You can see some of the debris left behind. This is just like a flaky stuff, but anyways, I'm gonna hop down off of here and we're gonna start looking at taking off all of the trim that holds it on around the edges, front and rear, and we'll see what that looks like and get going on that. Just to give you an idea of what I deal with, the dog that you always hear barking. Let me give you an idea where he's at. That's right. He climbs a ladder. I'm not talking about a ladder. I'm talking about like straight up and down ladder. And he can see over my fence. And he gives me the business when I'm out here working. So every once in a while, he'll go back inside through his doggy door. But then he'll come right back out and start giving me fits. My apologies. I've tried to reason with him, but he does not budge. He is not up for negotiations. All right, so I'm gonna start removing these termination plates or whatever you wanna call them. They've got a lot of lap sealant all around, which I'm gonna have to dig out. And they've got this little waterproof little insert that I'm gonna strip out. I've got some replacement that I'm gonna put back in there to help hopefully waterproof those screw heads. Anyways, let me rip this apart here and we will get going on working our way around this thing. I don't know how long it's gonna take. We'll keep an eye on it. It's noon, so let's see how long it's gonna take to get all these off here. All right, it took a minute to get this thing going. It's like rotten. Now it's coming out pretty easy. Oh yeah, look at that. Didn't even have to move my ladder. Not too bad. Real quick before we get going, this tool, 5-in-1, 4-in-1, whatever you want to call it, I buy the Bates Choice. These things are awesome. If you don't have one, you need to get one. You can poke, you can pry, you can cut, you can use it as a putty knife, you can use it as whatever. I use the snot out of these. I'll put the link down below. But let me tell you, if you don't have one for the price, I mean, just trust me, you can use it for a lot of different things. So if you don't have one, be sure to get one, make your life a lot easier. Especially just simple things like getting the corner of these going, which can be very difficult because of how rotten it is. Works great, and that little point allows me to work down through there if I need to, get stuff pried out. So again, great tool. Pick one up if you don't have one. Make your life much easier. Real quick, I just started working my way through these. Man, look at the rust on those. Yeah, my hands are dirty. I apologize. I've been working, okay? Look at that. That does not give me much confidence in terms of what's gonna be inside this. So I'm gonna get the rest of these pulled off and then I'll check back in with you once we start pulling this piece off. All right, get all these bits out. It's time to see if we can get this off without tearing it up. Doesn't look like it'll be a problem at all, so. We're gonna pull the rest of this off. I'm gonna need both hands, so. And then we'll go from there. Keep working our way around. There is some rust around this. Oh, let me readjust here. And it's a little concerning, but I think, I don't know, it's around a lot of these staples. So I don't know if there was just condensation in there and, you know, I could rust around these staples or not, but let's see. I don't really see any wood rot. I know there'll be some back in here, so. I don't know. Let's go ahead and get the rest of this trim off. I know I've said that like 3 times, but let's go ahead and do that. I'm not gonna piddle with anything else until we get all of that off and we can get a good assessment of what's going on. So, I may have to pull off these verticals as well, just based on some of the damage that's gonna be under there. But let's get down off here and need to quit talking and focus and get some of this done.
All right, so I've got that trim piece, those termination strips pulled off on the sides and the back. The front's got a little bit different configuration because that front cap rolls over the front top of the roof, so I'm gonna address that later. So now I'm gonna work on these corners and getting these pieces off of here. All right, I've got this back corner piece off. It looks like, now that the screws are out, there are some staples that were kind of holding it in place, probably just to allow them to get those corner pieces on there. So, and as I was looking down, there were a few more staples into that occasionally through the aluminum siding. So we're gonna have access now to the wood behind there, and you can see there's some of these staples that are gonna have to be pulled out. Look at how rotten that is. It's moving the whole thing. So yeah, we're gonna get on that. Let me regroup here, drink a little coffee, and then we'll catch up with it in a minute. I'm working on this termination strip up front, and these screw heads are proving to be a little bit of a pain. The lap sealant's so old, I'm having a hard time getting it off there. So I'm having to dig each one out individually. So that's the current status. I'm gonna have to do that for the duration of the length, which may take, could take a little bit of time. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna have to just dig all these out individually, go ahead and screw those off, see if I can get these undone on the ends here, and then we'll see if we can peel this thing back a little bit. I was mentioning on one of the earlier videos how much I like this little 4-in-1 or 5-in-1, whatever you wanna call it, but it's proven to be really, really handy yet again. So it's making light work of the lap sealant that's around those screw heads. So I'm actually making pretty good progress getting these out. Okay, let's see if we can get this gently pulled up. I think underneath this termination strip, the siding is stapled into the plywood. So you have the decking, the rubber membrane, the siding, which is stapled in there. Then you have this strip, which is screwed in. So I'm just gonna go through here real gently and pry that up to make sure I don't damage anything, but I wanna be able to get this up all the way across. So just continuing on with this, prying it up gently. The siding is stapled to the decking, but it's coming loose pretty easily. You also have the adhesive from the roofing material that's stuck to the plywood, so we're kind of peeling everything off in layers. We got this peeled up. You can see the insulation under here. The wood's all good. We're gonna have to clean up. There's some staples that are left over. You can see them from place to place. So I'm gonna go through here and get all of that cleaned up. I need to get this strip off of here still, and then this roofing material. You can see how far it went under there. It ended here. This is underneath the siding, and then it went another, you know, 4 or 5 inches beyond that, kind of overlapping the insulation and all that good stuff. So we're just gonna replicate what they had from the factory when we put this back on. Got some wood here. We're about to get up top and reinforce that ceiling or the roof there, and then we will get going on installing this. What I'm going to do is I'm going to rebuild this one truss and get that beefed up, and then we're going to scab in a replacement kind of fortify that. And then they didn't have 3/8 OSB at the lumber yard I went to. This is 3/8, so I went ahead and got sanded 3/8 plywood. That way I don't have to deal with any perfection. It doesn't sink, it'll be better for the rubber material, the EPDM that's going on the top. So that's what we're gonna put up there, and that's where we're at. All right, so that's what this looks like. You can see where this is rotted out. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut a board. It'll go from here down to this healthy portion here. And I'll bring it over, slip it in, and I'll use this pre-existing one to make a template, right? So I'll have the right arch on it. And then I'm basically gonna just scab it in here to this healthy portion, tie it into this good wood here, and just leave it next to this. I don't think I'm gonna cut that out. I may just spray some mold treatment on there and be done with it. So I'm gonna go cut that 2x, and I'll bring it back up here, stencil it out using that as a template, and then cut it to fit, and then we'll come back and install that thing. So that's what we're gonna do, and we'll see how it fits here in just a minute. All right, so we've cut this, and I had tapered it off to fit the curvature of this other one. So that matches up within a 1/16 of an inch. It'll match up perfectly whenever I get done with it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna screw it into this top and bottom, back on this healthy wood. I'm gonna treat this with some anti-mold, mold killer, stuff like that. I'll tie it in up here into this wood. Believe it or not, this wood's actually good. It's got some discoloration, but it's not too bad. I think it's worth using. So once we do that, I'm gonna go ahead and insulate this thing, and then we're gonna slap some wood up here and see what it looks like. So we're back up on the roof, and we are gonna go ahead and get this just truss supported and built back up so we can start putting some decking on here. I was thinking about leaving a little bit of this in here, but I think I'm going to cut out this bad spot just to make sure that that rot doesn't keep spreading. I don't know if it does that or not, but that's what we're gonna do. So I'm gonna cut out a little bit of this old stuff. We'll put this new piece in, and then I may beef this up just a little bit. I don't wanna add too much weight, but I don't think it would hurt to add just a little bit of support back into this thing. So let's get some tools up here and see if we can get this thing done. All right, let's see if we can get this thing. I've got this piece scabbed in here now. I cut off that rotten portion just to kind of clean it up a little bit. It wasn't supporting anything anyway, so we'll see. It feels pretty solid. This isn't really load bearing, but I at least want it to have the structural support that it did before. And then I just tied this in down here. It's solid. So we'll see. I'm gonna go inside and maybe take out a little bit of this paneling that's on the ceiling, and then we can take a look up underneath it and see what it looks like. If nothing else requires any repair on this section, let's go ahead and get a sheet of plywood up here. I'm gonna put some construction adhesive down on these trusses, and then we'll set it in place. I'm going to dry fit it first just to make sure everything fits okay. And then we'll throw some adhesive on these boards, and then we will stick it on there and go ahead and get that thing affixed and see what it looks like. I didn't go with OSB. I couldn't find any true 3/8 OSB in stock anywhere, and I didn't want the height difference to cause any issues, you know, in terms of water pooling up or whatever. So we found some 3/8 plywood that I'm just gonna work with, and we'll see what that looks like. This is what the inside looks like. There's the piece that I put in, and then I've got this sheet of paneling terminates right here, obviously. Maybe not obviously, but it terminates right here. What I'm going to do is, I'm actually gonna put another piece, maybe just like a, just a small little chunk. Let me see if I can get the light. I want this to come out a little bit so you can see here. I need the board to come out past this point so I'll have something to screw into or to staple into with the new paneling. So I'm gonna add a little piece on there. Basically, that'll come out and kind of mirror what this is doing all the way across. So just something to support what I'm gonna be affixing this paneling to. I've got to figure out, that sheet goes all the way over there. And it goes behind this slide here out to the other side. And then if you look this way, there's this partition that's in between the two. And then that sheet ends over here, which we have lights and air conditioner duct and all kinds of things. So I need to figure out what I'm gonna do in terms of just cutting this thing off halfway through. Maybe where the next truss is, I don't know. So we'll start tearing that out. And this one's gonna have to come out also because it's got some rot on it. So we'll get that tore out as well. Yeah, and then see where we go from there. Right, I'm not sure exactly how I'm gonna cut all this out or what I need to cut out specifically. So what we're gonna do, I'm gonna start cutting this out in sections and see if, see if there's a point where I can get to the end of the rotten stuff without having to replace full sheets. That's kind of where we're at right now. And then we'll go from there. I tell you what, I'm gonna hop up top. I'm gonna work this multi-tool around the edges to try to cut some of this loose, and then we'll see what rot we have and what's salvageable, if anything, and then we'll go from there. A lot of debate and going back and forth, I think that I'm going to just square this up and cut out that section where I can just cut one to fit and put it in there and then just trim it up. It'll look kind of awkward with trim going around, but that's just going to be the way it is. For me to get a full sheet in here, it's pretty much not going to work without, just because of the dimensions. I mean, we're like right at 4 feet. Almost exactly, and none of it's gonna line up on these trusses in terms of me being able to put it up there. So what I'm gonna do for now is just square this cut up. I'm not really gonna worry about patching it right now. That'll come later. I'm trying to get this thing dried in so we can avoid any additional water damage. But the wood there's pretty good. I mean, it has a little bit of discoloration, let me see, from some of the previous water, but it's solid, and as bad as the rest of it is, I'm not going to worry about it. I have been treating it, in case you're curious, with this Moldex mold killer. So it's supposed to prevent the growth of it, of mold and mildew. Clean, deodorize, disinfect, all that good stuff. Anyways, that's what I'm using. I'll put a link to it down below, but I'm treating anything that I'm not replacing that looks like it may have a little bit of mold, mildew, rot. I guess I shouldn't say rot. If it's got rot or if it looks like rot, I'm replacing it. But I haven't removed any of this stuff yet.
and it's in bad shape, obviously, and a lot of it's gonna get removed. However, I have been treating all of it just in case. You know, there's some of this that I'm gonna leave it. I'm not gonna replace that, but I have been treating it already, so hopefully that helps keep this stuff from spreading. And I could be making a mistake with that. I hope not, but that's where we sit. So next step is getting out the pencil and the square and making some straight cuts on this. And man, I'm telling you, I haven't really used one of these multi-tools a lot in the past, but this thing is a game changer for me. I'll drop a link for it too. Let me tell you, it is handy. It cuts through wood, metal, all kinds of stuff. So if you need to run a straight cut next to a board, just to get something out and make it easy. I mean, I was able to zip right along that, no problem. A lot of control, easy to use. I don't know, I'm a big fan. So anyways, I'm gonna get to work. This is starting to sprinkle a little bit outside, so I wanna get this piece of decking on here. So that's what we got next. We're now working under the cover of a tarp. We had a emergency rain delay, and I tried to get everything tarped up because I've got so much exposed right now. The back end of the trailer, I've got all the siding stripped off, so all of that good wood is now exposed to the elements, but I hastily put a tarp over it and we're good to go now. So I'm back inside trying to do a little bit of work that I can inside here. I'm gonna try to start ripping out some of this stuff. Here's a view from the top side of that back corner right above the bathroom. And to give you an idea of what I've gotta do here, you can see this is completely trashed, right? I need three of these. Need one to match that over there, here, and then we got this one. And then of course I'm gonna have to replace all this wood here, and then this piece here. That's actually good wood, so the damage only goes down just a little bit. So with that in mind, actually maybe I'll just cut all of this out and we'll just start rebuilding it from scratch. Let me cut three trusses and then we'll go from there. I'm cutting three of the supports for the ceiling trusses right now. I've cut one already. Actually, I've cut two of them and I'm just using this one as a template. And yes, I'm using my top of my smoker for a sawhorse currently because everything is tied up and or wet. So basically I just cut a 2x4 to length, put it up next to one of the existing trusses and use that as a template. And cut a couple of these, went ahead and made sure they fit. And now I'm just using the previous one for a template. So just gonna sketch this out and then cut it up real quick. And then we'll see if the three of them fit. I have all three of these cut. I got a good fit there. It's flush all the way across. I'll anchor this into what's existing. I'm gonna cut out some of this old stuff, and if it's crumbling, it's coming out of there. This piece is so rotten here that I'm just kind of pulling it out by hand. And there we go, you can see. Those are completely rotted through, which is okay. I'm gonna replace those, we've got those cut. This part in here, if you can see that, it's really rotten until about just before this electric here. So maybe I can cut that off and then get a piece in. Of course, this is rotten, so that's gonna come out as well. Of course, everything is odd sizes. This piece here, it's like a 1x1.5, which is just an odd size. So I've got some 1.5x1.5 boards that I may have to run over the table saw. And then these obviously are rotted out, so I have those cut already, ready to replace. So let me do a little bit of digging around here and see exactly what I'm going to cut out. I've got some of this cut out now. As you can see, a little bit of rot up there that still needs to come out, but I'm going to go ahead and start cutting some of these replacement boards. So I'm gonna have to rip some larger lumber down to size, since these are so odd. And then we'll start putting this back together and see if we can get it structurally sound again. I made a little progress here. I've got these two boards fit. You see there's a little bit of gap there. That was just because
one of the boards is slightly bowed, but everything's flush on top and on the exterior. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring in another board, put next to this one, and brace this up. And I think I'm going to come in and add another board on top of that just to give me something to nail to whenever it comes time to replacing these trusses. So I'm not sure yet how I would cover that up with the trim and stuff like that, but I may not. I got a couple of different options there, so we're gonna have to work through it, and I'll show you guys what I come up with as soon as I get it done. I've got this built up now, at least to the best of my ability. I've already beefed this up. I put an extra truss in here just to give it a little bit more support, because it seemed very, very weak even when I followed kind of the factory design. I went ahead and added another little support back there, and that beefed it up quite a bit. So now we're really strong now. All the lines match up. I need to get some scrap paneling and fill this little void here. You can see where they had, like, I'm assuming it's paneling. It looks like it. There was two sheets of that kind of sandwiched together behind there, and then it followed the length of this over to the end. So I'm gonna find some scrap paneling and fill that in back there and go ahead and staple that in. And then this should be done. I'm gonna see about using the piece of OSB that I pulled off here as a template and see if I can get that, the holes lined up properly for those pipes that come up, those vent pipes. Other than that, I'll cut the rest of this stuff out from the inside. All right, here's what we've got on the inside. Everything is nice and braced up. I'm gonna get rid of this piece right here. That's gonna go away. I don't think there's any mold at all. I could be wrong. I think it's just water damage. However, I've treated everything with a mold killer, so I'm hoping that that is good to go. I'm going to go ahead and probably cut out this entire sheet of plywood here. And then this one as well. I'm probably gonna have to remove the sink and all this junk, because I'm gonna have some water damage over here in this corner on the floor decking. So I'm gonna have to get access to that and fix that. And then those wood frame rails that run around the edge of the trailer frame under the subfloor, that's gonna be rotten mostly. This is good to go. I'm gonna go get my plywood, see if I can get the pattern matched up that had the holes for the vent pipes, and get those cut so maybe we can get some plywood on here. Well, we had a little bit of a setback. This is what I like to call full transparency. So I was real excited, right, about getting this thing all beefed up and sturdy. Unfortunately, as you guys probably already noticed, everything inside these two rails is skylight. So I've effectively filled up my space for the skylight. So what I'm gonna do is take those out. I'm gonna move these to the outside. And I'm going to take this one out, and we're going to relocate it to another location. Either way you look at it, I need to get those out of there and fix this problem so I can actually try to get the plywood on before it gets dark on me. So, okay, we're back with a proper solution this time. I have moved beyond the hiccup I had, and this thing is once again really sturdy. But I have the room for the skylight now. So the new trusses onto the outside where they should have been in the first place. I replaced that one completely. So I ripped the other one out, which I was gonna do, extended a new one, and then tied this little cross brace here to give it some lateral support. So we're good to go now. And I've got the holes cut on the plywood, so I'm gonna dry fit it and see what it looks like. All right, we are up on the roof again. I'm going to start cutting out these rotten sections of decking that's up here. And I'm just gonna take it over here to this seam. I don't think there's a need to replace the whole thing, to be honest with you. There may be. Let me look over here. That looks like it absorbed a little water at some point, but it is not. Look at that, a couple of screws that had pulled through. I'm gonna need to pull those out. It's not bad. The rest of this is actually in excellent shape. It's just this corner over here. So I'm gonna take it to the seam here. And then I would like something to go across here that I could screw to. So I may add in a piece. That way it'll be something solid to screw into here. We'll section this off. That way it'll be a nice square cut whenever we replace the other piece of plywood or OSB. And then this over here, this is really soft where I'm standing. And I don't know, I think it's because those trusses have been compromised over here on this end. Now that I think about it, I may just rip out this whole piece and this piece and just replace both of them. That might be the smartest thing to do, then I don't have to worry about it. The rest of this wood's in excellent shape, so that would give me a little more of a peace of mind, and I can use it for a template to cut my holes in the other one. In this one, I'm covering it up completely, so I can just rip it out and then start working on repairing those trusses. So maybe we'll do that. I haven't got as much done today as I wanted to. Some things have just kind of drug along, so that's just the reality of it. I really need to get this cranked up. We got a little stretch of nice weather, so I want to get all the rotten wood replaced. I want to get everything insulated. I want to get the new roof on and get everything back up on top. That way we can shift our efforts to the interior, which is gonna be some work too. So that's the plan. Let's see if we can figure out, looks like there's a lot of nails in this thing. So let's see if we can figure out how to pry it up without tearing everything up and get these things off. All right, well I got busy and forgot to record, but all I did was pry this one piece of plywood off the top. Pretty straightforward. You don't need me to show you how I did it, but I will say, it had so many nails. I mean, look at that. It was on there good, but we got it off. No big deal. So I'm gonna use this for a roof, a loose template. And another discovery down here, this stuff is rotted out beyond all belief under here. So I gotta figure out how to replace that. I don't know if I can just slide a piece in there or what, but that's gonna have to be done somehow. And that I mean, it's rotten all the way across. It gets a little better in the middle, but then look at this. That is just, I mean, unbelievable. The plywood's rotted, everything is rotted. So I gotta figure out how to do that. I have no idea, so I'm gonna have to do a little homework. Everything above it is okay, you know? There's that moisture barrier that's under there that has done a decent job on everything up above. I'm gonna go up top, look at that other end, maybe start trying to pry that board off or that piece of OSB up top. And then I'm gonna go over to the hardware store, the lumber yard, and get some wood so I can start trying to patch some of the stuff together. That's where we're at right now. Let me get this mess out of the way so nobody steps on it or so it doesn't fall over on one of the kids. And we will get going with that front piece. All right, well, we are going to start ripping out this front piece here where we have all of the water damage from the leak around the antenna. As soon as I get that down, I'm gonna head over and get the wood that I need to start fixing this thing. And we'll start cutting and patching stuff together and reinforce this ceiling so I can get that OSB back on there. And then we'll get everything cleaned up, actually. I'll pull that termination strip off the front. We'll get that off of there, and then we will go ahead and lay that roofing material in the near future. So that's gonna be good. So let's get this going and see what it looks like under there. So I'm gonna go around the edge of this and make sure that we don't have any nails or anything that's gonna keep this plywood from sitting flush. So I'm gonna check all that, and then I'm gonna get everything staged up. The plywood is up here. I'm going to glue everything. I'm gonna put some marks on the end so I can snap a chalk line where these trusses are. That way I can screw into those and not miss anything. That way we can get it fixed up there solid. So we're gonna get everything staged up. I'm probably gonna throw in some staples too from my pneumatic brad nailer or whatever it's called. I'm a little hesitant on the screw heads. Yeah, I'm gonna sink them down as flush as I can, but I don't want anything rubbing on the roofing membrane that we're gonna put up here. So that's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna go ahead and get this thing prepped up, and then next time we check in, we're going to try to get this thing on here. So that's where we're at. We are one step closer. I don't know why I decided to wrestle with this thing for a bit, but it's fit. Everything is fit nicely. I've got it all screwed down, and everything's flush. I'm gonna put seam tape on these seams and then around these sharp edges, just as a preventative, make sure we don't have any unnecessary wear and tear there. Next up is finishing up this corner here, and then I will cut for those. We will slap this piece into place, and then the roof will be ready, minus cleaning up. There's a lot to be cleaned up. I still have to take this off and get that dressed up, but that's not a problem. So yeah, we'll put some seam tape on, like you can see here. We'll get this off and we'll put new stuff on there, and then yeah, it should be ready for the EPDM roofing material. And then we will move on to the next phase, which is all the rotten stuff down at the bottom. So a lot of the wood that I've been uncovering looks pretty good so far, but the bottom, the very bottom, and a lot of the floor decking is garbage. So we're gonna work through that. Not a big deal, it's just gonna take a little time. I got the old sheet of OSB that came off the top, and I got it lined up on top of my new plywood here. So I'm all set up. I'm gonna go ahead and cut these two holes. I may mark this one and go ahead and cut it too. This one obviously is not quite good shape. I could mark a couple sides there. I don't know, but for sure we'll get these marked, and I want to get these. If I can get this these cut, I can fit this piece of plywood and maybe get it buttoned up today. So that's the goal, and that's what we're gonna do now. All right. We finally have this sheet up here temporarily after a lot of setbacks, mostly user error, and then one other one whenever I finally got it up there to dry fit, it was actually about, I don't know, 3/8 too long on that edge, down to about 5/8 too long or too wide, 5/8 extra on this end. So I had to measure that, snap a chalk line, and cut the excess off. Holes from pipes lined up pretty good, can't complain there. I may have to take just a hair off of this side once I get in there, but I'm okay with that. And I had used the other sheet of OSB to kind of dry fit these, and it was rotted out around where the skylight is, so I was only able to get these two sides cut, but I figured that's a good start. We will mark the rest from the inside, or I'll just cut it from the inside when it comes time. I'm not too picky either way, but I just took the brad nailer and slapped a couple of brad nails in each corner just to hold it in place. Not a lot, but there's supposed to be some wind tonight, so I wanted to get it fixed and kind of shaping, and then I wanted to prevent the wind from trashing the rest of the insulation and all that good stuff. So that's where we're at right now. I will get this thing tomorrow. We'll get her glued and get everything screwed into place. Finally starting to get it covered. I'm just patching in an hour at a time, so it drags on a bit. But we've got it in place, and we will permanently install it next time we're out here.
So this sheet of plywood is just sitting up there. We kind of stapled the corners just to hold it on briefly. You can see I pre-cut these holes using the old sheet for a template, and we're just a hair off. So just on this side, the other side fits great. So I'll clean that up. We have the skylight over here that I was able to trace part of it because of what was left. Half of it was rotted. I guess it rotted off already, so I wasn't able to cut the whole thing. So I'll, this is off a little bit here, which I can clean up. I'll get the saw, my sawzall, and cut it from the inside and make sure that's all trimmed up. But for now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go outside. We're gonna pull this piece off. We're gonna make sure everything's in place up top and that we're good to go. And then I'm going to get the construction adhesive out, cover everything up that we need to make sure we get a solid bond between the plywood and the trusses. And then we will get this thing stabbed on here and secure it up. And then we can start getting everything prepped for the new roofing material. So that's where we're at. We have this final piece secured up here. We're good to go there. Like I said earlier, we still have to cut out the portion here for the skylight, but we'll do that from the inside. So this one looks pretty good. It's just a hair off on this side over here. I need to shave off just a scotch bit there. I'll do that from the inside, but we're good to go here. So next thing is going to be undoing this, cleaning that up, getting it where I can get the roofing material up under there. And I'm gonna tape all of these seams. And believe it or not, we may try to get the roof on here in a little bit. I'm hoping the wind stays down. If not, we're gonna have to work around that. But next step, taping the seams, getting the front prepped up, and seeing if we can get the roof on. I'm working on this termination strip up front, and these screw heads are proven to be a little bit of a pain. The lap sealant's so old, I'm having a hard time getting it off there. So I'm having to dig each one out individually. So that's the current status. I'm gonna have to do that for the duration of the length, which could take a little bit of time. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna have to just dig all these out individually, go ahead and screw those off, see if I can get these undone on the ends here, and then we'll see if we can peel this thing back a little bit. I was mentioning on one of the earlier videos how much I like this little 4-in-1 or 5-in-1, whatever you want to call it, but it's proven to be really, really handy yet again. So it's making light work of the lap sealant that's around those screw heads. So I'm actually making pretty good progress getting these out. Okay, let's see if we can get this gently pulled up. I think underneath this termination strip, the siding is stapled into the plywood. So you have the decking, the rubber membrane, the siding, which is stapled in there. Then you have this strip, which is screwed in. So I'm just gonna go through here real gently, excuse me, and pry that up to make sure I don't damage anything, but I want to be able to get this up all the way across. That way we can put the new roofing material up under the... So just continuing on with this, prying it up gently. The siding is stapled to the decking, but it's kind of goes pretty easily. You also have the adhesive from the roofing material that's stuck to the plywood, so we're kind of peeling everything off in layers. Go. We got this peeled up. You can see the insulation under here.
The wood's all good. We're gonna have to clean up. There's some staples that are left over. You can see them from place to place. So I'm gonna go through here and get all of that cleaned up. I need to get this strip off of here still, and then this roofing material. You can see how far it went under there. It ended here. This is underneath the siding, and then it went another, you know, 4 or 5 inches beyond that, kind of overlapping the insulation and all that good stuff. So we're just gonna replicate what they had from a factory when we put this back on. You can see, maybe, got everything on the roof. I'm gonna start going around and taping these seams up and getting all the corners. I'm actually just gonna use this heavy duty Gorilla tape. And if I think there's an area that may be a little more abrasive or sharp, I'm gonna double up on that. You can see here the remaining portion of the skylight that I have to cut out. So I'm gonna start working my way around. I'm gonna get this stuff taped up, and then I'm gonna go ahead and tape the seams that run horizontally across the roof up here, and make sure that there's no raised edges or screw heads or nails or anything like that that's gonna interfere. So that's what we're gonna do now. I'm just slowly working my way around with this Gorilla tape. So it's taking a little bit of time, but it'll be worth it in the long run. So I'm gonna keep doing this, and we'll check in with you whenever we get all the way around the sink. All right, let's get the rest of this edge trimmed up here and make sure all that fits nicely. Let's see if we can get this cut out of here. I have to, once I get it out, I'm probably gonna go ahead and screw it down to these trusses. That way it'll give it a little more support like I did on this back one here. And then I'll clean up these edges once I get in there. Get up on top and take a look, and maybe we'll take the jigsaw and clean that up. Okay, I have the skylight and the vent fan. I got it cut out and everything's pretty flush, close enough anyways, and I went ahead and put some Gorilla tape over those edges just because they were slightly jagged. I knocked down the rough stuff, but I just wanted to make sure, so I went ahead and just added another strip of that over it just to give it a little bit more cushion between the sharp edge or the edge and the roofing material when we get it on there. So we are good to go up here in terms of this prep. Obviously we'll clean it off one more time before we start putting any material on here, but next thing is I'm gonna go around the edge of this where all of the trim pieces or the termination trim, whatever you want to call it, where that's gonna go on, and I'm gonna go ahead and clean up all of the leftover butyl tape and lap sealant and all that mess. So I'm getting all the final preps done before I start putting this roof on. I went ahead and cleaned up all these edges the best I could, getting rid of all the old lap sealant and butyl tape that was on there. Again, best I could, so we can get ready for the roofing material to get on here. I'll give it another clean, make sure everything's good. We're going to go ahead and pressure wash these trim pieces real quick just to make sure I can get them as clean as possible prior to putting them back on there. I just want to give us the best chance at getting a good seal. So we're going to pressure wash these. As you can tell, my slab here on this little patio is a little bit dirty. We may have to do that later. Anyways, we're gonna pressure wash these and let them dry while I'm finishing up the other preps, and then we're gonna try to get this roof on. I got everything pressure washed. I think it did a pretty good job getting these cleaned up. It got a lot of the small stuff that I couldn't really get with a putty knife or a scraper out of there. There's just a little bit, but really you can't even feel it to the touch. So I think that we're gonna be good to go as far as that's concerned. Next step, I'm going to get up top and maybe use the blower, I think, to get the last little bit of debris off. And then I'm gonna bring out the material. I've got it rolled up on a cardboard tube, so the EPDM, a roofing material, and just kind of dry fit everything into place, and then we're gonna see how it's gonna work with the wind. So if everything fits, I'm gonna fold half of it back, go ahead and roll on the adhesive and get it laid down. So I'll probably just put that on time lapse or speed it up for you guys so you can see the process. Basically, it's just gonna be painting on the adhesive and smoothing out the roofing. So that's what we're gonna do. Hey y'all, welcome back to the channel. We've got the rubber roofing up on top. Now it's time for us to try and get the trim pieces installed. So we're gonna go ahead and get those up there best we can, get those screwed down. And then once we get that process done, we're gonna have to go around and trim off the excess and hopefully get some lap sealant on any of the points of compromise. If we have time, we're also gonna put the little vinyl molding that goes inside the little trim channel that kind of covers up the screw holes. So those are what's on the agenda. Let's get the tarp off here and see if we can get started. I've got the two trim pieces on the sides. I haven't trimmed off the excess yet, but I'm about to do the termination bar back here. But I'll climb up here, kind of give you a look of what it looks like right now. So you can see a couple of little wrinkles, like right in this area. That is actually just where I've got to cut out those holes for different appliances and vents and stuff like that. So those are all good. Everything's coming together nicely. I'm gonna go ahead and get this buttoned up back here, and then we will head up to the front. And you can see, yeah, we still have that flap up. So we're gonna see how much we can get done this evening. So all I'm gonna do, if you can see, all I'm doing is securing that temporarily because I've gotta put the metal back on the back of this. So I'm gonna hold that there just to keep the wind from ripping it up and making something happen that it shouldn't. That way it'll let me go work on the front, and then I'll try to get this back end put together. That way we can get that secured properly. The only downside is down here, putting that metal back on, I still have the damage down at the very bottom that needs to be addressed. So anyways, that's where we're at right now. And so we're gonna leave this kind of temporarily up there, and then we will go and work on the front. We have this front termination bar screwed in, so we're ready to go with that. I still have to get these corners here, but one thing at a time. Obviously it's not watertight yet. Once we get all the trim on, there's gonna have to be lap sealant and all that good stuff put on here. And then we gotta put the little waterproof cover that fits inside this rail. I hope it fits over these screws I use, which have a little bit bigger head on it, so we'll find out. But roof is looking pretty good. We should be watertight here pretty soon. So I had this tacked up overnight. I'm gonna go ahead and pull the strip down, get my metal reinstalled back on here and get that secured properly. And then we will start trimming this thing up and getting the accessories back on top. We are up here putting this insert into the trim molding that holds the roofing down on the edges here. I don't know what the official name for this stuff is. It is a just a vinyl insert molding that covers up these screws in here. Supposedly keeps out moisture and water and stuff like that. I still haven't trimmed this off. I'm gonna get this extra roofing, the excess trimmed off when we get this all on. So I'm not gonna be able to film this and do it at the same time. So I'll go ahead and work my way down and get all of this inserted, and we'll see how it turns out. Here we are. We're about to get after it again after a few days of rain. So let me get this tarp stripped off here and we'll get started. This is the gasket kit that I got in to replace the worn out stuff that was on the bottom of the air conditioning unit. We're going to flip this thing over, or at least get it up on its side briefly, just to put the new gasket on there. And actually I may do that once I get it up top. Anyways, either way you look at it, I hope this works. It doesn't seem like it's quite as firm, but I think it should work in terms of compression gasket. And then we have some of the, I guess, leveling pads. They help support the areas of the air conditioner that aren't resting on the gasket. So like normal this time of year, we've got some more rain coming in for like the next week. I want to get this up there, get everything buttoned up nicely before that sets in. Take one on this thing, and you can see where this gasket, I may have got about half of it off clean. And then we started getting these sections where it was just stuck on there really, really well. And I had a hard time getting it to come off clean. So I'm brainstorming right now, trying to figure out what to use. See what I pulled off there. There's my helper. I'm gonna try to figure out what to use to get the rest of this nasty stuff off here and get it cleaned up so we can get good adhesion for the new gasket. Here we are. It's much cleaner. I also kind of boogered it up a little bit, trying to get that dang gasket off of there. It was a pain. As a matter of fact, I'm probably standing on it. I ended up using a little bit of, I used some brake cleaner to kind of loosen that adhesive up a little bit, and it worked all right. It still took a lot of elbow grease, but now I need to get the rest of this cleaned up because it's still got some of that sticky residue on there. And of course, if I put any imperfections on there other than just superficial stuff, I need to smooth those out and make sure that's not going to be an issue. I finally had to resort to using a old washcloth and gasoline to really get a lot of that adhesive off there. The good news is, despite what it looks like, it's actually clean, and I think we're going to be able to get good adhesion for the new gasket, which is what I really care about. So that's where we're sitting right now. We still have to figure out the best way for one person to get this up on top of the camper, which is not an easy feat. And once we get it up there, I'm gonna put the new gaskets on and we'll see if we can get this thing secured down. Well, I managed to wrestle this thing up here and I have the gasket stuck on, and then the little support gasket back here on the back just to support the weight on the backside. I'm gonna go ahead and position this and then move inside for the final centering on it. This is somewhat in position now. I'm gonna head inside, take a look up through the AC opening and see how close my bolts are to lining up, and then we'll go ahead and start seeing if we can get it tightened down. You can see here, we're a little bit off. This side, we need to go back this way a little bit. Front to rear, we're not too far. And then you can see how this is recessed a little. So I'm just going to straighten that up, make sure everything's fitting properly, and then we'll start taking a look at the wires and get everything bolted in. I think we're pretty well centered in here now. Out of the way. Remember, we have to plug that back in. So that all looks good. All right, we're nice and centered. On to the next step. For this unit, we have two different little wiring harnesses to plug in. This little bundle here will simply plug into this clip here. And then we have the smaller two-wire plug that hooks up inside this little panel. So I'm gonna pull this off. We'll get inside there, get both of these plugged up. That's all the wiring I have to mess with. Then we will fit this back into the opening and see if our bolts line up, which they should without much trouble. And we'll get this thing tightened down. We're not gonna over-tighten it, but that gasket should do its job and provide us some waterproofness up there. As you can see here, I've got this bundle plugged back in, and I have this bundle here, the black wires with the blue clip, that is plugged back in. That's all the wiring I have. I'm gonna go ahead and put this plate back on right here, and then we're gonna see if we can get this thing stabbed in there and bolted in. I believe we are good to go. This contact paper that was on here before was wrinkled up, I guess, from the installation originally. I'm not sure, so we'll figure out what to do with that later. But as of now, I don't know if you can see that very well, I didn't tighten it down real tight. I'm gonna let the gasket do the job. We've got a little bit of
compression. I say we've got some good compression there all the way around. The unit feels secure. We're gonna go up top and take a look and see what's going on there. But outside of that, I think we're about ready to put the face cover back on it and get it cleaned up just a little bit and out of the way.
There you have it. As you can probably hear, it's blowing strong. Everything seems to be working fine, so we're gonna go ahead and get this covered up inside and then head up top and get the shroud put on. All right, this still needs some cleaning up, but it's running and we've got the base plate back on there. There's a clip that's been broke for a while that goes right here. And you can see some of the dirt stuff still on there, but I'm gonna pull that off later and get it washed up nicely. I just wanted to get it back on there today. Let's see if I can, there we go, quieten it down a little bit. Anyways, this is good. Let's head up top and get the shroud back on the unit and see if we can get this thing covered up before the rain hits. Just for an overall update, this is where we sit right now. The vent covers are on, butyl tape's down on all this stuff, but I haven't used any of the lap sealant yet. But these are in place. The vent over the bathroom is in place. I have not cut the hole yet for the skylight. That's gonna be my next step, but I'm still waiting to do that. Your refrigerator vent is taken care of. We got the AC installed, the cover back on it. It looks a little grody, but that's as clean as I can get it, so that's where we're at. We have the radio antenna that I still need to mount and take care of. I ordered a new one. The old one, the base plate was trashed, so I'm waiting on some parts to get in. I have not got the termination bars sealed yet with lap sealant, but front and rear, I don't know if you can see that or not, but anyways, I still have to work my way around doing all of that, but all in all, it's moving along. It is coming together. Then I'm gonna have to transition inside, so one thing at a time. I'm just happy to be getting it done.